tell me first about your ideas, idea about the Sudanese. You said, how do you see them?
Well, I when I'm with the Sudanese, my heart completely opens and I am in another realm. It's very angelic. The people are very pure, and I don't mean as naive, but there's an innocence or uncorruptedness by what most humans are in this world. I think there's something very important, though, that people aren't aware of. And Sudan, I want to relate that a lot of the troubles there have been obviously oil, and which has split up the north and the south and everything. But if you are looking from the space Hubble and you're looking at the earth with infrared lighting and everything, there is a trench that comes down near the Nile, and it's the molecules that create air and water. And air and water is peace. It's not oil. So if I'm looking for people here of Earth or people from another planet or whatever, the highest riches are right there buried beneath the sand. And I believe that water is peace. And so future water will be the answer. And this trench is near the Blue Nile. I have it written down, but the thing of it is 90% of the air and the water on the planet Earth comes from the molecules in this trench that's buried underneath the sand. And it is blown with the wind, the Sahara winds, and it lands on top of the rainforest. We get 90% of the air and oxygen and water from these molecules. And just a little bit of it trickles out in plumes into the ocean and spreads around the world. And that's where we get our air and water. And it's from these molecules that's buried under the sand. That's the truest, wealthiest riches of our planet. And we're looking, it's not oil. And
For what is coming in the future of humanity, what do you think or you see as coming? What is coming?
Well, I think the veils are very thin and it's going to be revealed. There's not going to be a lot of confusion between dark and light, and everything right now is being exposed for what it is. Everything's unraveling perfectly. It's all in divine order. Everything has to come down before it can be rebuilt. So we're really getting ready to go into the next act. We're in the final stages of this.
What are the signs of that we are in the final stage?
The signs we're in the final stages are, first of all, you'll find yourself in a lot of synchronicity, and that's because when you're in synchronicity, you're in complete alignment with what is, and that is that we're all one. And once everybody wakes up and realizes that we're all one, the real true shift changes, because if you try to hold anyone down or anyone back, you're actually just holding yourself back. Everyone is just an aspect of who we all are. But the Sudanese will lead the way. You know, there's less ego there, there's a simplicity, more purity, and we probably came in through the planet in Sudan, and when we leave to go to the next realm, we're going to probably go out the way we came in. As we all know, Sudan is shaped like the heart, and I do believe it's the heart of the planet.
How soon do you feel that this change is happening?
Well, it's happening now, and it's happening rapidly, and it could happen within weeks, really. I don't see it going for years at all. It's not, you know, maybe a few months, maybe weeks. It's going to be really like a blink of an eye. Because once we reach that tipping point where more people know that we're all one than don't, the mass consciousness will just shift. And then people won't even remember that they didn't know.
Okay. About this point where things will change and will come, what is after the change? What do you see after that? When it comes, what is coming? Is it?
Love wins. There will be no war. Uh-huh. We will start to forget what war even was. Uh-huh. There will be just random acts of kindness. Everyone will be helping each other. We'll be collaborating, and it'll be the end of competition and the beginning of great collaborations.
Why is this happening? Why will it be like that?
Because that's nature. That's the laws of nature, that everything should be copacetic and in a flow where, you know, they call it, I guess the Taoists say we're in the river going on, and it's a flow. It's not in the order of the universe for us to be, this is mine and I am better and you're not part of, and that's just not the laws of nature. The laws of nature are we're all one big ecosystem.
Okay, until this happens, what are we supposed to do? What is it required of us to do now?
Oh, that's a very good one. It's happening regardless of what we do. But I think people make a mistake and go, oh, it's happening, and then they just sit back and, you know, think about themselves and realize it's happening. But meanwhile, there are still people suffering. The people that are, some people are not even in the search of anything spiritual. It's just not in their genes. I think they call them laggard souls. And a lot of us came in with a soul contract that we would come in and we would wake up and we would come back down and come get the people that we're not looking, because everybody has to go. If we're all one, we can't leave people behind. So I recently had spent some time with a friend of mine who is a Carmelite nun, and she said that she had met with three people who had died and come back. And one of these people told her that they found themselves in judgment, but judgment wasn't what they thought it was. Judgment wasn't about what you did wrong. Judgment was about all the things that you did right, and which makes much more sense, because if you're going into heaven, you'll be in a state of bliss, and you're not going to be in a state of guilt. So everything's a little bit the reverse of what we thought, and it's beyond our thought, but it's beautiful, and it will continue to get even more beautiful than what I think the human mind can even imagine.